promises tough times for human traffickers in Nigeria. Release kidnapped students of Federal College of Forestry Mechanization, Akafa Kaduna, reunites with families, promise to continue academic pursuit. And on a sad note, President Muhammadu Buhari mourns death of former Women Affairs Minister. All these and more in just a moment. Good evening, it's nice to have you on NTA News at 7. I am Paul Abel. Now the news in details. Preparations are in top gear towards the hosting of the 4th National Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Awards in June this year. The MSME Awards is instituted by the federal government to honor and further encourage players in the sector in their contributions to national growth. State House correspondent Jide Onifade reports that a slight change to the awards portal has been announced, which will open to interested MSMEs from the 10th to the 31st of this month.
The 4th National Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Awards will be held as part of activities marking the World Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Day coming up in June this year. The last three editions had showcased talents from across the country in various categories. This fourth edition, coming up in June this year, will involve a week-long activities, which will be capped with the awards ceremony to mark the World Micro, Small, Medium Enterprises Day.
The portal or the site has moved to www.msmeclinics.gov.ng. In the past, we used to have .com, but it's now moved to a safer site. Basically, so we'll be expecting a lot more people on this site. This year, also, the portal will be open from the 10th. We're expecting that it's open from the 10th of May, 2021, and it will be open for 3 weeks.
Of course, these awards are meant to target certain sectors that are key to driving the growth in the MSME subsector. And we're encouraging all MSMEs that have special skills, that have special knowledge in these areas, to come and apply for this, because that's the way of the government saying thank you to these enterprises for helping us grow the economy the way it's supposed to be grown.
The federal government desire to empower and support micro and small enterprises across the country led to the National Micro, Small, Medium Enterprises Clinics in 2017. The idea of the Micro, Small, Medium Enterprises Awards was equally generated in 2018, and it's one of the initiatives that arose from the clinics. Jide Onifade, NTA News.
Still in Abuja, there is no longer any hiding place for human traffickers in Nigeria, no matter how highly placed or connected. Director General, National Agency for the Prohibition of the Trafficking in Persons, Iman Suleiman Ibrahim, said this when she had in an audience with the management of the Nigerian Television Authority in Abuja. Adebola Bruce Sunday reports.
For the Director General of NAPTIP, Iman Suleiman Ibrahim, the largest television network in Africa, NTA, is the best place to be if our agency must reach all parts of Nigeria.
Our citizens have become commodities for sale.
Her plea to the NTA Director General, Yakubu Ibn Mohammed, is to assist the agency in fulfilling its mandate of coordinating all nations' crime prevention and stamp out human trafficking and uplift the vulnerable from exploitative tendencies.
We don't want to wait for people to become victims. We want to come strongly from the preventive angle. That's what our renewed vision as an agency represents.
We must collaborate with each other.
The NTA DG, who described human trafficking as a pandemic, said the fight against the societal ill is the business of all.
It can lead to slave labor, you know, it can lead to prostitution. It can also lead to death, you know, in the hands of harvesters of human organs. So it's important that Nigerians get to know the risks that they run, you know, in going out of Nigeria at all costs.
Both heads of the two government agencies agreed to set up a four-man committee to fast-track the implementation of their collaboration.
We're going to intensify in an aggressive and disruptive public enlightenment campaign to ensure that our people are fully aware of all the danger signs and they're able to kind of respond, and also key players in this fight against human trafficking.
The NAPTIP head said the agency will always be ahead of those who are bent on human trafficking and other similar human rights violations in the country. Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
In a similar development, Nigerians in Diaspora Commission has called on the leadership of Nigeria Association of Women Journalists to scale up strategies to stop the menace of unnecessary journeys across the desert and the Mediterranean by women and young ladies. NITCON Chairman Abike Dabri Erewa says this when she received an audience at 12-member National Executive of NAWUJ, led by its president, Ladi Bala. Correspondent has details.
The NITCON boss expressed satisfaction with the visit and assured of collaboration, noting that the partnership with the National Agency for the Prohibition of Trafficking in Person, NAPTIP, will bring a significant reduction in woman trafficking.
So yes, government has a role, but we also have a role. And I believe that if we educate them, talk to them more, we'll save some other people. Who is going to fall a victim of a trafficker?
The national president of NAWUJ, Ladi Bala, commended Abike Dabiri Erewa for her accomplishment in fighting for victims of vain troubles abroad and promised effective partnership to eliminate the exploitative practice.
We believe that as women journalists, we have the platform and we have the tools to speak and add value to the work that you are doing. We want to collaborate with the commission to ensure that those issues affecting our women in diaspora will also speak for them and advocate for them in such a way that they will find respite, you know, in how they go about doing their things.
The NAWUJ president urges Nigerians to shun any offer capable of turning them into tool for modern slavery, as there are more opportunities at home than in diaspora.
Kidnapped students of the Federal College of Forestry Mechanization at Faka in Kaduna say they will not be deterred by their experiences in the hands of abductors as they are resolved to continue to pursue their education. Suleiman Abdullahi Rigachiku reports that this is coming after they were reunited with their families.
Tears of joy, excitement, and gratitude to God as the abducted students reunite with their families.
I hope to come back and continue with my studies. I see this as a pathway to success.
We passed through hungry, trekking, whatsoever. We passed through insult. But unfortunately, they did not assault any of us. They did not kill any of us. So we just thank God.
For 55 days, they were in captivity of bandits who have kidnapped them from their college hostel midnight of the 11th of March.
Yes, I'm very happy because the trauma we went through for these 58 days has been undone by the joy we have today.
God is so wonderful. He has heard the cries of we, the poor people, because almost all the parents in this very school, we are masses. So God has heard the cries of the masses.
The advice and suggestion on the lips of the State Commissioner of Police and also the parents, likewise the teachers, is that this challenge should be a source of strength for the students to come back in full force and continue with their studies.
The command is appealing to the general public for more support in terms of information sharing and prompt report of incidents via our dedicated phone numbers.
Umar Muri also gave assurance that the police are making frantic efforts for the rescue of the kidnapped students of Greenfield University. Suleiman Abdullahi Rigachku, NTA News.
Still talking about security matters, the FCT Police Command has reassured residents to cooperate with the police. The police command wishes to reassure residents of adequate protection of lives and property in the Federal Capital Territory. This reassurance is necessitated by a viral publication in the social media suggesting areas which the FCT is vulnerable to Boko Haram attack. On the contrary, the command has deployed overt and covert strategies to curb banditry and other criminal activities across the territory. In addition, the command has launched a renowned social engagement strategy to address the security concerns in the FCT. Hence, all members of the public are enjoined to provide useful information to the police and other security agencies rather than circulate messages capable of causing undue panic amongst the well-spirited residents of the FCT. It is on this note that the command wishes to reaffirm the resolve towards the protection of lives and property within the Federal Capital Territory. The command further implores residents to report movements or any emergency distress should endeavor to call numbers 0803-200-3913, 0806-158-1938, 0805-733-7653, 0802-894-0883. And to report the conduct of police officers to these following numbers with the Public Complaint Bureau, and it is 0902-222-2352. A new sector commander has been posted to the Cross River State Sector Command of the Federal Road Safety Corps, FROSC. He is Corps Commander Ucheja Isaac Ame. He was enlisted into the Corps in 1996 and has served in various capacities. A statement by the Sector Public Education Officer Mark Ajuka indicates that Corps Commander Ucheja was the Sector Commander at Damawa Sector Command before his recent redeployment to Cross River State Command as the 19th Sector Commander. The new Sector Commander Ucheja reiterated the commitment of the Corps to work in synergy with stakeholders in creating a safer motoring environment in the state, while soliciting cooperation by the general public to enable the command deliver on his mandate. It's at this juncture we'll pause for a commercial timeout. Don't forget, you can equally watch these newscasts on our YouTube channel, YouTube/NTA Calabar. We have more stories for you at the other side of the break.
Everyday events occur, and as they occur, we bring them to you anywhere you are. News updates showing on your channel of choice, NTA Channel 9 Calabar, afford you opportunity to get it fresh, hot, and loaded. 3 minute newscast of headline story every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You can't afford to miss it. It is the news update on NTA Calabar, the station for the people.
It's good to have you back on the news. We start the second segment with stories on the political scene as well as the judiciary. The Supreme Court has affirmed the nullification of the 74 political parties deregistered by the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC. In a judgment delivered by Justice Adamu Jairo, the court affirmed that the deregistration of NUP, one of the 74 parties, was done in line with the laws and compliance with the extant provisions of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1999, as amended, and the Electoral Act. INEC, in deregistering the affected 74 political parties in February 2020, stated that they failed to meet the minimum requirement. In another judgment, the Supreme Court declared the Katsina State Government dissolution of local government of elected officials in July 2015 as illegal. The Apex Court ordered that the dissolved elected council officials be paid all their entitlement from the date of their illegal dissolution to the date they were to vacate office. The court described the act of the state government as illegal. The Apex Court also declared the dissolution of the elected officials of the local government in Oyo State as illegal. The court ordered the Oyo State government to pay all their salaries. The expected impact of this year's theme of the World Press Freedom Day is reverberating among media practitioners in Nigeria as stakeholders are being reminded of the need to reject the pressure to twist facts for the profit of personal aggrandizement, as well as distorting or misrepresenting facts. Achebong Basi reports that Dr. Joseph Ekpan of the Department of Mass Communication, University of Calabar, in a lecture to commemorate the event in Calabar organized by the Nigeria Union of Journalists, Cross River State Council, and the Brotherhood of the Cross and Stir, called journalists to abide by the tenets of journalism.
The theme of this year's World Press Freedom Day, Information as a Public Good, reaffirms the vitality of the press and the duty they owe to members of the public. Media practitioners are therefore being taxed to publish information for the good of the public, to create a peaceful and harmonious coexistence among various ethnic nationalities in the country.
It is bureaucratic that you turn out reliable, verifiable information which will require the public.
While commending journalists for the sacrifices made to set the agenda for a better society, the leader of the Brotherhood of the Cross and Star, Olumba Abu, encouraged newsmen to remain committed to upholding the virtues of truth.
If the information you report is false, exaggerated or distorted, people will be misled, and so will their decision be.
The freedom of information law guarantees every media practitioner the access to information is to the best.
An appeal is also made to the Cross River State Government to provide the needed infrastructure to the state media outfit to thrive effectively. In Calabar, Achebong Basi, NTN News.
Residents of Ekot and Kebre are decrying the suspension of the ongoing World Bank-sponsored remediation project at the gully erosion-ravaged community. With the peak of the rainy season setting in, there are fears that the development may plunge the community into woes again. Justina Etem reports that this is another cry for help from another gully erosion-threatened community in the state.
Ekot and Kebre community has suffered serious devastations occasioned by a ravaging gully erosion, which has consumed not less than 35 houses, displacing many persons, until help came the way of the community through this World Bank-assisted intervention project. Just when the people are rejoicing over the intervention, there is another problem, as there are fears that the project may not be completed soon due to alleged interference from government agencies, which has led to the suspension of the remediation work.
We have been redeemed, we have been revived, we have been returned to a stage of where we have hope.
And the recent one that caused the job to be halted now is the one that is on ground, that the company was attacked and their drivers beaten, macheted, wounded, and they were taken to the hospital. But appeals have been made for them to be allowed to continue with this work before the proper rain will set in.
Appealing to the World Bank to intervene on Newmark so that they should appease the company to return back to site.
The contractors handling the remediation work say the first phase of the project is under 95% completion, alleging that a group stormed the site some weeks ago, attacked workers and carted away their equipment.
We had some invasion about 3 weeks ago from hoodlums. They came in on the pretext of the fact that Aquaven was not paying levy for sand mining, which is laterite. So but from record available to us and interactions that we had with the agency responsible for those levies, which is the Cross River Internal Revenue Services. We have paid even up to end of April all levies accrued to the state.
In that regard, the negotiations are going on. We have made effort to see how we can meet with the security personnel to see how we can meet up.
It is the hope of residents of Ikotunkebre community that help would come their way soon before the peak of the rainy season sets in. In Calabar, Justina Etem, NTA News.
And now to the COVID-19 situation across the country. 39 confirmed cases of COVID-19 have been recorded as at 8 May 2021. Lagos has the highest number of 23 cases, followed by FCT Abuja and Zamfara, as well as Kano with 4 cases each, while Akwa Ibom, Gombe, Nasarawa and Plateau states recorded 1 case each. This brings the total number of confirmed cases in the country to 165,340, with 155,454 persons discharged, while 2,065 persons could not survive the pandemic. And on the foreign scene, the United Nations Security Council has stressed the importance of upholding multilateralism and cooperation globally towards safeguarding world peace. The decision was reached during a high-level meeting held virtually with member states' representatives. Adebola Bruchlin Sunday reports.
Multilateralism and international cooperation, which underpins UN Charter and 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, is fundamental to promoting and supporting the pillars of peace and security, development and human rights. President of the 75th General Assembly, Volkan Bozki, told the Security Council on Multilateralism that multilateral diplomacy has gained mileages on a number of issues, which implies that upholding the system has played key role in maintaining world peace.
In fostering dialogue and trust, managing security challenges such as terrorism and weapons proliferation. And it provides a framework for states to resolve disputes peacefully and without coercion.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken said the U.S. respects multilateralism, which is why it rejoined the Paris Agreement on Climate Change, the United Nations Human Rights Council, and the World Health Organization after withdrawing initially.
At the same time, we will continue to push back forcefully when we see countries undermine the international order, pretend that the rules we've all agreed to don't exist, or simply violate them at will. Because for the system to deliver, all countries must abide by it and put in the work for its success.
The meeting was chaired by Chinese State Councillor and Foreign Minister Wang Yi, who is serving as this month's United Nations Security Council rotating president. Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
And on the sports scene, the Minister of Youth and Sports Development, Mr. Sunday Dare, has affirmed that Nigeria can only assemble the best athletes in an open national trial where everyone will be given equal opportunity to qualify for the Olympics. The minister described the national trials as an important avenue to determine the best of Nigerian athletes to be selected for the international meet. He urged the athletes to remain focused and to avoid distraction. Meanwhile, some members of the Olympic-bound Nigerian relay team arrived Texas, USA for camping and competition. And now, on a very sad note, President Muhammadu Buhari is deeply saddened by the death of Hajia Aisha Jume Alhassan, who was Minister of Women Affairs and Social Development during his first term in office. The Nigerian mission in Cairo, Egypt, announced the passing of the former minister and senator. President Buhari said the demise of the notable politician Aisha Jume Alhassan has left many saddened, both in office and out of office, are concerned for education of the girl child, especially those of government girls' secondary school Chibok, who were abducted by Boko Haram terrorists, shone through. Her death is a huge loss, not only to the female gender activist community, but also to the country as a whole. He stressed that the condolences of the government are towards the family, towards the friends, the National Assembly, and the government, as well as the good people of Taraba State. And to end the news, a quick look at some of the stories that made headlines. The Director General, National Agency for the Prohibition of Trafficking in Persons, Iman Suleiman Ibrahim, has warned human traffickers in the country that there is no longer any hiding place for them, no matter how highly placed or connected they may be. The released kidnapped students of Federal College of Forestry Mechanization at FACA in Kaduna State have been reunited with their families, as they also express their resolve that the experiences they went through in the hands of their abductors will not deter them to continue with their educational pursuits. And on a sad note, we also brought you a report that President Muhammadu Buhari has expressed deep shock over the death of a former Minister of Women Affairs and Social Development, as well as APC gubernatorial candidate. That does it for the news tonight. On behalf of the entire crew, have a wonderful night rest.